it's a really good show. There are no easy matchups on this card. There's three debuts and they're all in proper fights. So starting off, I did actually have an iPad. The battery ran out.
So old school, yeah? Pen and paper in it.
We've got an old school, yeah? Pen and paper.
Can't beat it.
You don't see that on Sky Sports, do
you? No, definitely not. 100%
not. It doesn't matter, though.
For the realist of boxing fans.
Here, aren't we? So, starting off the show, we've got Kane Lewis. He's from Ireland. He's a really good fighter. Now, what I know about Kane is he went away and fought in Spain very early in his career against a good prospect and lost. But you know what? That shows that he's willing to get on the road and he's willing to take on tough fights. He fights Luke Fash tonight, who's really experienced. He's had nearly 90 fights. Yeah. So at the end of the day, it shows that Kane Lewis is willing to take on good challenges.
Listen, from what I know of the kid, what I've just heard there, listen, anybody who's willing to get on the road, go down that route, take on people like that, you've got to give him one credit, and that's the heart. So hopefully we'll see plenty of that in tonight, and we're going to expect a really good battle between him and Luke Flash.
There you go. So that kicks off the show, and that should be approximately 7:30.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, our opening bout of the evening, Mr. Lee Eaton, in association with Inco Boxing, proudly presents 4 rounds of action in the super lightweight division. Sanctioned by the British Boxing Board of Control, our supervisor here at ringside, Mr. Matt Harris. Our timekeeper at the bell for this bout, Mr. Tony Dunkley, and our referee in charge of the action when the bell rings, Mr. Stephen Gray. So introducing to you first, fighting out of the red corner, his official weight on the scales, 9 stone, 12 pounds, 5 ounces. An experienced boxer wearing the black and white shorts from Hull, presenting Luke Fash. His opponent tonight, standing across the ring, boxing out of the blue corner, his official weight on the scales, 9 stone, 6 pounds. He enters the ring with a professional record, 2 victories, 1 draw, wearing the green and gold shorts from Ballymun Island, presenting King Kane Lewis. Our referee, Mr. Stephen Gray, to give his final instructions.
Okay, boys, have a cold break. Take a step back. Don't deliberately throw punches to the back of the head. Protect yourselves at all times. Touch gloves.
Yeah. So here we go. Yeah. First fight of the evening. We're at the Sports Connection Leisure Centre in Coventry. I'm Chris Maylett, and I'm joined by Ricky Gorman, heavyweight boxer. He's doing a bit of everything tonight, a bit of presenting and a bit of commentary.
I'm juggling all sorts here, Chris. I'm juggling all sorts.
First fight of the night, Kane Lewis against Luke Fash. Now, Kane's from Ireland. There's a record of 2-0-1, and a good prospect by all accounts.
Most definitely working a lovely jab here, throwing in some lovely body shots.
Now Luke Fash, he's had 92 fights, knows his way around the ring, and is a have gloves, will travel kind of guy, and he's been in with all the prospects, Ricky.
Yeah, most certainly. You can see there, you know, he's not just standing still, you know, he's moving. You can see he's giving him a detour around the ring.
You can see already, Ricky is a very
durable cookie.
Yeah, and Kane is a good boxer. You can see he's got all the fundamentals.
Yeah,
most definitely. Tidy boxer.
Most definitely, you know, he's, as I say, everything what's looking good with him so far is coming off that lovely left jab.
We've got a really good bill tonight, Ricky. You've just been speaking to Aki about it. Top of the bill, Raza Hamza against James Beach Jr. for the IBO Continental Featherweight title. And the undercard has a lot of good prospects on it as well. A couple of debutants. So we're in In for a good night.
I think anyone who's watching this show at the moment's in for a real treat. We've got some really, really, really good fights on the card here. And at the end of the day, you know, you've got a title on the line here. And Azaramda and James Gates, a brilliant fight. Lovely shots there.
As we say, everything off the jab in boxing, and you know, a good boxer who's going to have a career always needs a good jab, and Kane Lewis here has certainly got one. And like you said, everything's off the coming off that.
Most certainly, definitely is. You know, he's pumping the left hand out lovely when he is getting into range with it.
End of round one. Good first round there.
Brilliant first round there.
Round number two underway. Kane Lewis against the durable Luke Fash. He's had a look at him, Ricky, in the first round, Kane, and he's coming out here now and he's looking to sink them in a bit.
Well, certainly is. He's coming out with bad intentions, but he just wants to be careful of the counter here from Flash. Look.
Kane's corner there, tell him to watch out for the right, and Luke slips a little sneaky left in there.
When he's fighting relaxed and on his jab, he's boxing really nice, you know, and he just needs to maintain. If it's not broke, don't fix it, just keep doing what you're doing.
He's a very neat boxer, isn't he, Kane? Doesn't do much wrong, you know. He's you can see he's got all the tools in the box.
Yeah, he's got nice feet. He looks like he's got good hand speed. He looks like he carries decent power as well, from what I'm listening to here ringside.
Looking at Kane's record, Ricky, he's had three fights. He drew his second fight. It was in Spain against Duan Yin, and he drew that. That was in Spain. And Duan Yin, who he drew against, was an unbeaten fighter. He fought him on his second. So I'd be interested to see what he was doing in Spain. Here he is in Coventry, and the lad's from Ireland. So again, he's that I said about Luke travelling, and it looks like Kane Lewis is a fighter on the road.
You know what I can gather with this, the young lad Kane here, he's a game kid. He doesn't look like he gives much of a care for what's coming his way. You can see what kind of a sort of a talent he's got. He just wants to fight, and he's making a good very nice sort of two rounds here of this opening bout.
And you do get the impression, you know, he could probably do this all night, and Luke Fash would you know, be there all night like this.
Gum shield.
But it's always good to see the young prospects, you know, turn it on with these road warriors or journeymen, and you know, do something a bit different. So as these rounds wear on, it'll be good to see him, you know, turn the screw a little bit and make Luke earn his money tonight. Round number three of our first bout of the evening. Kane Lewis versus Luke Fash.
Beautiful jab here.
What would you like to see Kane, we said about him maybe turning the screw in these last couple of rounds. What would you like to see here from Kane? And if he was his corner, Ricky, what would you be saying to do? Are you happy with what he's doing at the moment here? He's not doing anything much wrong, but...
He's not doing much wrong, if I could be honest with you. With your opponent constantly walking away to your right, maybe to double the jab up and then, you know, shoot downstairs with the left hand to the body. You know, forget the right hand to the body, start shooting the left hand downstairs. Beautiful, there's that left hand to the body there. Beautiful, there again.
Yeah, he's looking for the shots, isn't he? Looking to work on different things. It's nice that going to the body, and he's not just looking for the head. You know, the body doesn't move, and you've got. Luke Flash is in a fight every, you know, every week or every few days, it seems like. Yeah. He knows his way around, and you've just got to be that little bit cuter, haven't you, with them? If you've
got to disguise it with these roadmen, you know, with these road warriors, you've got to disguise everything you're doing with them, because, like you said, if he's on that, doing it week in, week out, he's seen it all. So you've got to be really, really sneaky in your disguises. Lovely counter there from Flash.
Well, Ricky, it wasn't long ago you was making your pro debut. Like you said, this was the actual ring that you made your debut in.
Yeah, most definitely. You know, I was the first person to box on a Vinco show against Milan Punev. So, yeah, thoroughly enjoyed it, you know. Can't wait to be back out there doing my thing again, you know, ASAP.
And when will that be? When are we expecting to see you out again?
It'll definitely be early next year, very early next year. As soon as I get confirmation, obviously, you know, you boys will know first.
We're looking forward to that, Ricky.
Yeah, can't wait, brother. Beautiful, gum shield's gone again. Beautiful uppercut there from Kane on the inside, and again. Oh, and again, the trade in here, Chris.
He's getting them in there.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Nice work there.
Brilliant, man.
Seconds out for the fourth and final round.
Fourth and final round of this first contest of the evening. Kane Lewis, Luke Fash. And Kane Lewis, as expected, has pretty much won every minute of the fight.
Beautiful left to the body there, Chris.
And he's
gum shield's out again. It's gone again. It's the third time now with this gum shield. You know, the referee better start saying something now, you know.
Yeah, he certainly knows what he's doing. And it flew out, that one there, didn't it?
Really,
I don't know
if a
shot landed there, I don't know. He got some purchase on that. He's had a look here, hasn't he, for three rounds.
Most definitely. He's really laying it on thick now. He's just got to be careful with these counters coming back, though. And watch the heads on the inside. You know, these men can survive on the Titanic sinking. You know, they know what surviving is.
Gun shield again, Ricky.
Yeah, that's the fourth time, you know. And he knows.
It's either don't fit very well or he's catching a breather.
Well, I don't know about that. Being on the road week in, week out, I'm pretty sure it fits good. He's getting that breather. I think that's the right decision from my point of call, you know, four times of that happening, you know.
Yeah. Referee Steve Gray's very experienced ref, seen it all before.
Oh, well, lovely right hand.
He caught him there, Ricky.
Yeah, most certainly the legs buckled there.
Yeah, like bang on the chin, that, and another one. He's catching him clean here, and Luke's hurt.
He's got to keep his work clean here, not smother it, you know what I mean? Keep the distance like that.
Very accurate here now as well.
Most definitely. Punches in bunches here as well. There's that counter back from Flash.
Luke Flash will be happy to see this round out. He's really...
He's earned his money, hasn't he, Chris?
He has, and he's catching a lot of them shots there, and it's a good performance here. He's gradually just... The first round, he had a look at him, didn't he? Second round, up the gear a little bit. Third round, and here he is finishing strong now, so it's a really good performance here.
This fourth round, he's laying it on like butter on toast, isn't he, at the end of the day? You know, he's come out like a greyhound from the trap in this fourth round. But brilliant boxing here from Kane Lewis. Oh, caught again there with that lovely right hand.
End of the fight, and a good performance there from Ireland's Kane Lewis.
Yeah, most definitely, you know, very controlled there, you know, good performance all around, displayed his jab, displayed his variety of punches. Good kid, really good kid.
We'll get our verdicts from our MC, but I'm sure that's a 40-36 all day long.
I'd mostly be certain on that one.
But Ricky, just looking down the card next, we've got a debutant, Jackson Asagi, fighting Harry Matthews. Then we have Tion Gibbs against Road Warrior Jamie Quinn. Danny Quatermain, who's 6-0, he's fighting Sanjit Singh. Fight number five, Connor Downs against Reynaldo Sagina. I've seen him around all the time. He's got a lot of prospects. Callum Singh, another debutant. Fight number six, he's fighting Jake Pollard, again another Road Warrior. Fight seven, Sammy Lee, a debutant. This is one I'm looking forward to, but Commonwealth gold medalist at light heavyweight, very good prospect, someone you know of as well. We'll speak about him later on, Ricky. He's fighting Robbie Connor, and that's a good fight as well. He's an unbeaten fighter.
Yeah, most certainly, be a great.
And then the main event is the IBO Continental Featherweight title, Raza Ramza against James Beach Jr. And there's the result.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, after four rounds of action, we go to our referee's scorecard. Our referee, Mr. Stephen Gray, scores the contest 40-35 for your winner from Balmoral Island, Kane Lewis.
40-35, so he gave him a couple of points in that round when he shook him up. So he took the points off him, didn't he? Yeah,
it was the point for the gum shield.
Yeah. So good four rounds there for Kane Lewis to get the night underway. Good fight.